The lightweight division in mixed martial arts seems to be the sweet spot, producing names you've certainly heard of and some you haven't. 155 is a honey hole for tape study and the sport's most talented. One fight on the precipice of someone you may or may not know is France's very own Benoit Saint Denis. A ferocious fighter with no sense of the concept of pacing, Saint Denis fights as his quote, God of War nickname would lead you to believe. His lone loss is to Elizeu Zaleski dos Santos, a welterweight bout up from his normal weight of 155, which was also a short notice fight. Since paying his pound of flesh and admittance to the UFC, Saint Denis has won 5 straight fights, each via finish. His most recent was his show-stopping high kick of Matt Frevola at UFC 295. Long story short, Benoit Saint Denis is electrifying. In this film study, we will be looking at what makes Benoit Saint Denis tick. My goal is to define who Benoit Saint Denis is as a fighter and document his tendencies from his first 6 fights in the UFC. Benoit Saint Denis is more of a well-rounded ground fighter and prefers to club and sub his opposition. But, as the old cliche goes, all fights start on the feet, and Benoit Saint Denis has developed a striking game that punishes opponents for staying on the feet or to get him to a takedown. When watching Benoit Saint Denis, the first thing a film study will show is his reliance on the open side body kick. Being a southpaw, Benoit Saint Denis understands what strikes work for him very well. Every opponent he's faced and fought in the UFC has been an orthodox fighter, which means he is always faced with the mirrored matchup. In a traditional orthodox versus orthodox matchup, where the fighter's stances are bladed, a kick to the open side comes from the lead leg. But because Benoit Saint Denis is a southpaw, and he's yet to fight a switch hitter or another southpaw in the UFC, he's benefited from the rear leg being the kick to the open side. This allows Benoit Saint Denis to get his power shots into the body of his opponents and even up high, as Matt Frevola learned at UFC 295. When he's not blasting the body of his opponents with the round kick, Benoit Saint Denis is a power puncher that gets into brawls often enough. But his biggest shot with the highest consequence is his left. In wild exchanges, he will wing it through and hurt his opponents, which either drops them or pushes them back into the fence. Getting the fight to the fence is exactly what Benoit Saint Denis is looking for. Once he's pushed his opponent back into the fence, Benoit Saint Denis will shoot on the hips and press them into the cage. He does this to minimize the sprawl. While Benoit Saint Denis likes to shoot against the cage, he does not like to work against the fence. Benoit Saint Denis is well aware of the wall walk and its threat to getting out of a grappling exchange. As he has his opponent pressed against the fence, be it standing and fighting the hands, or a knee trying to walk up, Benoit Saint Denis will pull his opponent away from the cage. If the takedown is there against the cage, he will take it. He then works his system to ride the legs, similar as Khabib Nurmagomedov did. It's here that Saint Denis will work to turn the fighter away by spinning him on his butt and begin to work to the mount position. Once to the back, the playbook is simple. Benoit Saint Denis will first lock in the body triangle to control his opponent. From here, he will hunt down the rear naked choke and club his way to the submission. Benoit Saint Denis' insistence on the rear naked choke comes down to numbers, though one cannot be certain just how much he's thought this out. In a study from SJ Stell on Reddit, the rear naked choke is the highest submission finishes in the UFC up until the beginning of 2023. It accounts for a whopping 49.48% of submission finishes, just under half. But Benoit Saint Denis, who finds himself in the back mount much of the time, utilizes this as the highest percentage finish that can be achieved from that position. With the relentless forward pressure brought to the table by Benoit Saint Denis, he will occasionally find a fighter that gets in on his hips. When taken down, the God of War refuses to accept position and is looking for a reversal or to exit the exchange. Benoit Saint Denis' number one way of counter wrestling is to get to a hip and build up with a single leg takedown. He will look to create space with his hips, bridging out, or threatening the butterfly sweep. He creates this space, and it allows Benoit Saint Denis the opportunity to shrimp out and work his way up from there. He is also quite fond of the butterfly sweep in its own right. When being taken down, Benoit Saint Denis has the wherewithal to look for the butterfly hook as he's fallen when the dust settles from the shot of the takedown. He immediately looks to post and sweep. This study isn't to guss up Benoit Saint Denis for you and make you think he's a world beater already. There are some glaring issues that he needs to address. First is the fact that he's not faced a high-level southpaw yet. The open side body kick is his number one weapon standing, and if an opponent is in the same stance as him, that weapon goes away. At the time of this video's recording, Islam Makhachev is the UFC's lightweight champion, and he is also a southpaw. Benoit Saint Denis will want to take on a couple of southpaws before he starts to really ascend the lightweight rankings. Next are the calf kicks. In several of his fights, most notably his UFC debut against Zaleski, Benoit Saint Denis ate calf kicks galore. Several times he's been kicked to the point to where he's being knocked off kilter. There are some calf-kicking monsters at 155, notably Justin Gaethje and Rafael Fiziev. If he cannot address this issue, running up against one of them can be crippling. Lastly, Benoit Saint Denis has been caught in several fights with a knee up the middle as he's ducking in on the hips, looking straight down. Benoit Saint Denis needs to stop shooting from so far out and telegraphing his shots. In addition, Benoit Saint Denis needs to shoot to the outside of his opponent's lead leg away from the power knee. This is a similar concept that we discussed on Jailton Almeida avoiding Derek Lewis's uppercut in video past. Benoit Saint Denis is just the first in a wave of French mixed martial artists. After the country finally legalized the sport in 2020, the infrastructure to produce high-level athletes is being built and improving. Once forced to travel abroad to find training, these athletes can start to train closer to home at a lower cost. Benoit Saint Denis is a product of that. His career is young, but Saint Denis is a promising prospect with a lot of excitement surrounding him. This film study is just a glimpse of his two short years with the promotion. As he grows and becomes a better fighter, I hope to be able to study that even.